Okay. So we have that information, and we have all these business functions that we have talked about. Profit, revenue, and cost. Right, which we have called R of X, C of X, and P of X, right? Okay, and so it turns out the derivatives of these have special names. R prime of X is called marginal revenue in the context of business. The derivative of cost is called marginal cost. And the derivative of profit is called marginal profit. Okay. And it turns out all these functions tell us that interpretation that we were talking about. That is, for example, R prime of X gives us an approximation of R of X plus 1 minus R of X, meaning it tells us approximately the cost of producing or of selling this X plus first item. So when we talk about we'll find these, but we also want to talk about how to interpret these. So let's do a couple examples. So if A, find marginal cost. For cost function is equal to 175 plus 0.08x. Okay. Now, so C prime of X is equal to 175 just goes away, and I get just 0.08. Okay, so assuming this is in dollars, it means the cost, there's no X here, so this marginal cost is constant for all values of production. The marginal cost of producing 1 more unit at any time or at any production level is what I want to say is basically 80 cents. Okay, we'll look at some more, but this is an interpretation of slope, right? So I have this, do you remember that the derivative is change in y over change in x? My change in y is the change in cost over the change in quantity, because x represents quantity. So when I have a slope, you should really be thinking that this slope is 0.08. When I have that slope, it means that if I change X by 1 unit and produce 1 more unit, then cost goes up by 80 cents. So I want to write that down. So other interpretations. There's one. When I produce 1 more unit, cost increases by 80 cents. Okay? So it has this, there is this sense of slope. Is this positive or negative? Like, is cost going up or down by producing more units? You assume that cost will go up. And so you get kind of these interpretations. Okay. Let's do marginal revenue. So find marginal revenue. So if revenue is 4x minus 0.01 x squared, okay? The derivative of revenue is 4 minus, and this is 0.02x, okay? Let's say I have a question that says interpret marginal revenue when x is equal to, like, say 10 units are sold. Okay, so when x is 10, I'm going to just find r prime of 10, which is 4 minus 0.02 times 10. This should be, I think, 3.8, is that right? 4 minus, yeah, okay. Okay, so I have 3.8, and again, because this is a derivative, this is a slope, or really close to the slope of a tangent line, right? So it means change in y over change in x. So one interpretation would be the revenue. Oh, and you have to remember this is an approximation of r of 11 minus r of 10 from our marginal analysis. This is this r of x plus 1 minus r of x, remember? And so x is 10, so I get r of 11 minus r of 10. So it approximates the revenue realized, maybe, or earned, from the sale of the 11th unit is $3.80. Okay, another interpretation would be, let's see, in terms of slope, revenue increases by $3.80 when I sell 11 units instead of 10 units. Something like that. Okay? Okay. And similarly for profit. So the profit function will increase or decrease depending on, in the same kind of interpretation of kind of this marginal analysis. Okay. Now we also have in this section an introduction to average cost or averaging functions. The average cost will do just that. It divides, like, total cost over however many units you have, so that you get a sense of how much on average they're costing you. So, and this is denoted by average, putting a line over the function. So this is an average cost function, is C of x divided by x, which is the quantity. So this is the average cost function. Then if I take, I have to find this function first, then if I take the derivative of this function, this is called the marginal average cost function. Okay, similarly with revenue, you have an average revenue function, R of x over x. When you take the derivative of that, divide by x first, and then take the derivative, it's the marginal average revenue function. And same with profit. Average profit function. And then this is P bar prime of x is the marginal average profit function. Okay. So let's just find, let's just do an example. We find these. So example. So I have, let's just, I'm going to list some functions. C of x is equal to 145 plus 1.1x. R of x is 5x minus 0.02x squared. And then we can find profit. Profit, do you remember, is revenue minus cost. So I get 5x minus 0.02x squared. There's revenue minus 145 plus 1.1x squared. I'm going to take these parentheses off and subtract. Distribute this minus to both the 145 and the 1.1. And then I'll get, let's see, I think I'm going to get a negative. I need to combine these two pieces. So negative 1.1 equal to, oops, I don't want to do this in highlighter. Negative 1.12x squared plus 5x minus 145 is your profit function. Okay? So if we want to find, let's just find some of these, like average cost function. Average cost function. C bar of x is equal to 145 plus 1.1x all divided by x. If I wanted to find the marginal average cost function, this is the same thing as dividing these individually. So taking 145, dividing it by x, plus 1.1x over x, like that. Which is also the same thing in this second piece, these will cancel. Oops, it actually cancels. So there's no x there. It looks something like this. Okay. So then if I want to find the marginal average cost function, I take that function, c bar of x, 145 over x plus 1.1, and I take the derivative. Now, to do that, I have to turn this 145 over x into something I can take the derivative of. So this c bar of x is 145, and that over x is the same thing as x to the minus 1, right? So then I take the derivative. That's okay, so the negative 1 comes out front, negative 145 x, and negative 1 minus 1 is negative 2 plus 1.1. Or another form of this might be negative 145 over x squared plus 1.1 is the marginal average cost function. Okay. So, I mean, it's the same process for marginal revenue, for marginal average revenue, for marginal profit, for marginal average profit. Same procedure. So same, I don't, for these other functions. Right, form these average cost functions or average revenue functions, average profit functions, and take the derivatives. Okay?